تجويد أحكام النون الساكنة والتنوين. نحن قلنا طيب I will read up to where we have stopped. يقول راجي رحمة الغفور دوما سليمان هو الجمزور الحمد لله مصليا على محمد وآله ومن تلا وبعد هذا النظم للمريد في النون والتنوين والمدود سميته بتحفة الأطفال عن شيخنا الميهي ذي الكمال أرجو به أن ينفع الطلاب والأجر والقبول والثواب. النون الساكنة والتنوين. للنون إن تسكن وللتنوين أربع أحكام فخذ تبيني. For the noon, when it is in a state of sukun, it has four rules. Then listen to my clarification. فالأول الإظهار قبل أحرف للحلق ست رتبت فلتعرفي فلتعرف أن فلتعرفي أن أو فلتعرف so know it. فالأول the first rule ruling of النون الساكنة الإظهار قبل أحرف للحلق ست رتبت when the noon comes before one of the letters of the throat of الحلقية الحروف الحلقية للحلق ست رتبت فلتعرفي and then we said in the beginning of the sentence أخي هاك علم حازه غير خاسر قال همز فهاء ثم عين حاء مهملتان ثم غين خاء the همزة the ha, the ayn, the ha, then ghaynun kha, ayynun ha'u muhmalatani, then ghaynun kha, muhmalatani does not have that, muhmalatani. Wathani, as he said it here, you have it in number 8. Now in the page 6 of 12. No, I'm sorry. No, the 5 of 12. So he said, Hamza ha, then ayn and ha, without the markers, then ghain and kha. طيب, the second one. والثاني إدغام بستة أتت في يرملون عندهم قد ثبتت. So the إدغام comes when the noon is ساكنة or the tanween comes before one of the letters يرملون. Comes before one of the letters يرملون. Now, in Yarmalun, they have two categories, if you remember. Yanmu wa lam wara. Yanmu. So, if one of the letter of Yanmu, one of the letter of Yanmu, it becomes with Ghunna. Idghamun with Ghunna. If from lam wara, Idghamun without Ghunna. Idghamun without Ghunna. We wrote example and this is where we stopped إدغام بغنة بلا غنة so the إدغام without غنة all of you understand the إدغام right the إظهار we finish it the إدغام anyone has a question about the إدغام Idgham, we did it last week. Idgham. Any letter comes with noon. So we have noon, sakina, noon sakin. Noon or tanween. Noon. If letters comes after it, yanmu or lamra, lamra. Okay? If the letter that comes after noon tanween, lamra, what is happen? For example, min ladunhu. Min ladunhu. So when we have lam or ra, lam or ra, what happened? We cancel the noon and we replace it by the letter after it, which is in this case lam, in this in case ra. So it becomes, instead of min ladunhu, is going to be mil ladunhu. That's why we're going to have double L. Here, for example, min rabbih, min rabbihi. So the noon, we cancel it. We're going to replace it by the ra, and the ra we add it here. So it becomes mir rabbihi, mir rabbihi. We don't say min rabbihi, we say mir rabbihi. That's the idgham, the idgham. Huh? This is idgham bilashi ghunna, biduni ghunna. Al-idgham bi ghunna is in the yanmu, yanmu, yanmu. So for example, man yu'min, man yu'min, man yu'min. What we do, ya is from the letters of yanmu. So what we're going to do, we're going to cancel the noon, replace it by the letter that comes of it after it is ya. And then we're going to say, may yu'min, may, and we have ghunna, we stretch it, yu'min. Huh? That's the idgham bi ghunna. And we did this just as a review. Ghunna stretch. No. No. That comes in the ikhfa. The ghunna is the stretch. So we have ikhfa with ghunna. Idgham with ghunna and without ghunna. So depends on the letters that comes after the word that we are studying. So if the noon sakina, if the noon sakina, so every time you see a noon in a state of sukoon, is going to require a specific way how to recite it. Idhar or idgham, okay? So this is the four ahkam that he's mentioning. Idghamun, idharun, ikhfa'un. And the idgham we have, idghamun bi ghunna, wa idghamun bi ghayri ghunna. What are the letters that the idgham comes without ghunna? What are the letters? Lam and ra. What are the letters that idgham require to have ghunna? Yanmu, ya, noon, mim, wa, waw. So if we combine them together, we have six letters. They are yarmalun, yarmalun. Okay? طيب. قال والثاني إدغام بستة أتت في يرملون عندهم قد ثبتت. We have ألف أذان ما شاء الله. في يرملون عندهم قد ثبتت. يرملون. That's what. لكنها قسمان. But there are two categories. قسم يدغم فيه بغنة بينمو علم. A category in which this idgham, you add to it غنة, which is to stretch. In the letters ينمو, as you know. إلا إذا كان بكلمة فلا تدغم كدنيا ثم صنوين انتلا. If you have one of the, look, the noon and ya, if you have one of these letters of yanmu, this, they come after noon sakina, but inside one word. Because this here, as you're seeing, in two words yet, من يؤمن, من لدنه. I'm going to read some of the examples. But if the نون ساكنة and one of this letter comes inside one word, you don't make the idgham. Because if you make the idgham, you're going to change the word itself. Like dunya, dunya. Dunya, I have ya, and I have nun sakina. If I apply the rule, I'm going to be say duya. If I apply, so I say, do not apply it here because you're going to change the word. The other example that he gave us, sinwan, sinwan, is in the Quran, sinwan. If I apply the rule, it's going to be siwan. I said, what is siwan? You change the whole word. So I say, don't do this. Don't do it. Because you're going to keep the word as is to preserve the meaning of the word that is in the Quran. So the idgham is done for the recitation, to easy the recitation, to make it simple. And that is the language of the Arab. That's how they do. But they don't do idgham. So you don't apply the rule when it comes in one word. This is what he saying in this verse. What he said, قَالَ إِلَّا except إِذَا كَانَ the نُونَ السَّاكِنَة and one of these letters بِكِلْمَةٍ they are together in one word. فَلَا تُدْغِمْ do not make the idgham. Do not get them, you know, include them together. كَدُنْيَا example, دُنْيَا ثُمَّ صِنْوَانٍ تَلَى and another example, صِنْوَان. Okay? طيب. I'll give you examples from لام and را. لام and را. Example, مِنْ لَدُنْهُ مِنْ لَدُنْهُ we read it with إدغام مِنْ لَدُنْهُ مِنْ لَدُنْهُ هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ with إدغام how you read it هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ with إدغام you read it مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ with إدغام you read it غفور الرحيم غفور الرحيم okay طيب الإدغام بغنة الإدغام بغنة the letter of the إدغام بغنة with the stretching stretching is that غنة that غنة you add the time you stretch it من نعمة من نعمة إدغام إدغام only I say من نعمة I say when I add the ghunna becomes min ni'matin min ni'matin. You see that stretching that is the idgham. The stretching is the ghunna. To combine them together, which is the idgham, is min ni'ma. So I will have replacing the noon becomes one letter. Example, yawma idin min مارج خلق الجنة من مارج من نار من مارج so when I do the إدغام I'm going to cancel the نون replace it by the ميم so it's gonna become من مارج من مارج صح now when I add the غنة it becomes من مارج من مارج so that's the غنة So, idgham without ghunna, min marij. There's a qira'ah, they do idgham without ghunna. And hamza fi khalaf, without ghunna. Qul, for example, yawma idin na'im, wa man yu'min billah. He doesn't say, wa man yu'min. Okay? So, in our qira'ah that we're studying, the ghunna is added to the idgham to make the specification. If there's idgham, not necessarily there is ghunna all the time. Ghunna only when you have the huruf of yanmu. Another قال من مارج جزاء من. This one called idgham كامل. قال كامل بغنة وإدغام ناقص بغنة. This is more, give you more details. In ينمو we have two categories. النون والميم إدغام كامل. والواو والياء إدغام ناقص. What the difference? إدغام كامل, the noon is completely gone. You don't hear the sound when you have noon and mim or yanmu. For example, for the mim, we say mim marish. The noon is gone. So this is idgham fully, you know, included fully. Subhanallah, included in each other. That's dakhala. They enter fully, fully transformed. الإدغام الناقص, الإدغام الناقص, this kind of small sound of the noon, like from with wow, you say ميولي, ميولي, غشاوة ولهم, غشاوة ولهم, مي مي يقول, مي يقول, خيري خيري يرى, خيري يرى. But نحن just to give you this more specification, but know that إدغام غنة are the letter ينمو, are the letter ينمو. Okay, طيب. والثاني إدغام بغير غنة في اللام والراء ثم كررن. طيب. الثالث هو الإقلاب. The third ruling is الإقلاب. الإقلاب. الإقلاب has one حرف. Which letter? ينمو, ينمو. طيب. You can look back at the class of last week on video, we have it. Yeah. Now, الثالث الإقلاب. الإقلاب. So this is the third حكم. The third حكم of the نون الساكنة. What is name? إقلاب. إقلاب is to change the thing to another thing. قلب is to turn aside, to change it. إقلاب. 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 The letter of إقلاب is the letter ب. Only letter ب. Letter, what is the letter of the إقلاب? ب. So, if we know the letter of the إظهار and the letter of the إدغام and the single letter, the one letter of إقلاب, the fourth حكم is named إخفاء. إخفاء is to hide. The rest of the letter of the alphabet is إخفاء. It's easy. You have six letters. We have 28 letters, right? Six letters of إظهار plus six letters of إدغام plus one letter, 13 minus 28. The rest all إخفاء. طيب what is إقلاب؟ إقلاب is قال جعل النون الساكنة والتنوين ميما مخفاة بغنة عند الباء. To turn the نون الساكنة a letter ميم. So نون becomes ميم. ميم. مخفاة بغنة. You kind of hide it with غنة. الغنة is to stretch. Example, the one that comes in the Quran, Al-Anbiya, prophets. Okay, we have Nun Sakina, and we have Ba. So the combination of this, it becomes like Al-Anbiya, Anbiya. So we don't say so Anbiya, Anbiya. And you see it in the Quran, they take off the sukun and they put small meem. Read in the Quran, you see there's small meem. The small meem, this is, I changed the pronunciation of noon to meem. To meem, and I add a ghunna, stretch. Like min ba'di, min ba'di, min ba'di, min ba'di. So this one becomes here meem. Min ba'di, min ba'di. Al-an. الأنبياء الأنبياء عليم بذات الصدور عليم بذات الصدور ها عليم ب بس the noon sakina turn into meem and it with the ghunna. The ghunna caused the meem to kind of, you hide it, إخفاء, not fully. So, عليمٌ, عليمٌ بذات الصدور. I don't say عليمٌ, no, عليمٌ. الإخفاء is to say the letter with the lips are not pressing on the meme but opening. Like, just not pressing, just you put them on top of each other. Like, عليم عليم بذات الصدور من بعد not من بعد you see من this is I'm pronouncing the ميم this one I'm making إخفاء من بعد الأنبياء الأنبياء you see the difference. So that's what I meant by إخفاء. No, إقلاب pronunciation of the ميم with إخفاء and غنة. I said the ميم مخفات. The ميم مخفات. The ميم has إخفاء itself. I don't, if I say ميم ظاهرة, I, it becomes أنبياء, أنبياء. مِن بَعْدِ No, this is not how we pronounce it. We pronounce it with instead of pressing the lips against each other, it's just you put them on top of each other, like this. Instead of مِن No, I say مِن مِن بَعْدِ So the غُنَّة, what you hear, the beginning of the ميم, and then the sound of the غُنَّة who prevail in the end. If I sound the meme without, you know, stretching it, becomes like mim ba'di, mim. This is not the sound that I want. Say mim, mim. You see, in after saying the meme, now you're not, you cannot hear it because why? There's ikhfa. إخفاء hidden by the غنة مخفاة بالغنة من بعد عليم بذات الصدور الأنبياء okay any question did I say من بعد all together من بعد say it الحمد لله but the specification مخفات hidden mean with the غنة الإخفاء let's go pray and come back to the إخفاء so you pray your sunnah after the finish the class okay بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه أما بعد يقول الناظم والثالث الإقلاب عند الباء ميما بغنة مع الإخفاء you see he specified the إخفاء ميما بغنة مع الإخفاء فالغنة تخفي الميم فقالك باء نون تقلب الباء تقلب ميما مخفاة بغنة أي صوت الغنة the sound of the غنة he the one to going to hide the meme and hide the meme means like reduce the pressure that you do on between the lips becomes like معناها مطبوقة طبقا بدون أن تضغط عليها you put them together without pressuring on the lips not no من بعد من and the الخيشوم مخرج الخيشوم هو النزاليزيشن ليس أنه الحرف يخرج مثلا في الإخفاء The sound comes all from the noise, like me. No. You see, whatever I close here is going to come from this sound, but not all of it from this sound. Like not. No. So both together. That's the khayshu. That's the nazar, you said from the noise for years. قال والرابع the fourth one الإخفاء عند الفاضل very easy look قال the fourth one is الإخفاء for the rest of the letters عند الفاضل من الحروف واجب للفاضل it is required to have it الإخفاء إخفاء hide the noon so here إقلاب we hide it here we hide the ميم but الإخفاء we going to hide the noon what it mean hide the sound of a noon there but is not clear kind of there's a cloud on top of the noon comes from where from the sound of the nose واضح we're going to give an example طيب طيب الإخفاء معناه في اللغة الستر to cover kind of you put something covering it's like clouded cover النطق what it mean النطق بالحرف على حالة متوسطة ما بين الإظهار والإدغام مع مراعاة الغنة. So here the pronunciation of the noon between idgham and idhar, which is kind of you are covering it. You will not cancel it like the idgham, and not you will not pronounce it clearly like the idhar is between them. And the hiding, I mean the covering comes with the ghunnah. I'm gonna give example. The letters are the rest. 15 harfan. 15 letters. Are we calculated, right? Deduct the idhar letters plus deduct the idgham letter plus deduct the letter ba of the iqlab. We have 15 letters. They gather it in the beginning of this bait. صف ذاتنا كم جاد شخص قد سما دم طيبا زد في تقا ضع ظالما. This is, you know, some we find it in some of the books. But the rest is صاد دال ثا كاف جيم شين قاف سين دال طا زاي فا تا ضاد and ضا. These are the حروف, 15 letters, which is the remaining letters. So the easy for all of you to say the remaining letter is not ينمو, is not يرملون, is not هكا أخي حاز وعلم غير خاسر, is not those letters, is not ب, the rest. The way how to pronounce it, we're going to give example. Man sura, man sura, man sura, mim noon, sad, wawra, man sura. I'm going to man sura, we have noon sakina, and after it, what is the letter after the noon? Sad, sad. Is it from حروف الإظهار? No. Is it from حروف الإخفاء? And it is not ب. So it is from the إخفاء. Okay? I'm going to hide it and make ستر between, I said, إظهار and إدغام. It's going to be من, من, instead, من, من. This is, I'm doing إظهار with غنة. من اوكي ادغام وضغنا becomes مص مص you need because I cancel it I'm gonna keep it between them I'm gonna say منصورة من you see you hear the noon from the beginning and then it goes to kind of disappear into the غنة منصورة منصورة let's say منصورة من look بريح بريح صرصر بريح صرصر We have تنوين ريح and then the same is حرف صاد بريح صرصر this is إظهار I didn't do إخفاء so I'm gonna hide it ستر cover it with the غنة in the end of the غنة disappear بريح صرصر بريح صرصر Now I'm going to give you a good tip here. Only this is comes with the tasmiyah. The end of the ghunna need to be, you put your tongue where the next letter is going to start.
Therefore, the gunna is going to take the sound of the next letter. Look. Birihin sa. If I make a thin, say birihin sarsarin, you see, I commit here a mistake by making the sad thin. Why? Because I didn't prepare the ghunna to have that volume, to build that volume to start the sad. Birihin sarsar, birihin sa. Now, if I'll take another one, مثلاً من عندي, من عندي, من عندي الله. قل هو من عندي الله. Look, من عندي. The other say, صر صر. This one, why? Because the dal is thin. So the end of the ghunna, the tongue stop where the next letter is going to start. Min indi. See, min indi. Min indillah. I didn't say min say, what did you see? The other one, I have to give the volume because the letter is مفخمة. Say من قال بريح. You see how has volume. Why? Because I have صاد after it. بريح صرصر. قال وطعاما ذا غصة. وطعاما ذا غصة. So here the sound of the غنّة is need to be thin because I have ذا. I don't have wa there. وَطَعَامًا ذَا. وَطَعَامًا ذَا. I'm stretching more just for the example. Don't do that. وَطَعَامًا ذَا غُصَّة. You see, the ذَال comes natural. Why? Because you already prepared it. And that's the ghunna, that's the ikhfa. You hear the sound of the noon, it disappear with the ghunna, and the ghunna merge with the makhraj of the next harf. Therefore, the ghunna is going to take the volume of the next letter. وَطَعَامًا ذَا غُصَّة بِرِيحٍ صَرْصَرْ. Two. Yeah. I mean, من ذا الذي, من ذا الذي. I'm stretching it to make you hear the thinness of the غنة, or it's how heavy it is. Depends on the letter that. I'll give example. أنذرهم, أنذرهم, أنذرهم. من ذا الذي, من ذا الذي, من ذا الذي. من ذا الذي. It's too depends on the pace of the recitation. Okay. من ذا الذي يشفع عنده إلا بإذنه. من ذا الذي يشفع عنده إلا بإذنه. Now, so you see, it's too tempo, two times based on the pace of your recitation. How slow or fast. If you do it like slow, من ذا الذي يشفع عنده إلا. So this is too based on your, on this, the rhythm of your, of your recitation. واضح؟ Yes. It's too. If you on the measure of the tempo that you are choosing is gonna be too, طيب منثورة, منثورة, منثورة. من ثمره, من ثمره, من ثمره. من ثمره نطفة ثم.
You see, you have the ghunna, the noon covered, then it disappears with the ghunna, and the ghunna ends in the beginning of the next letter. So the sound of the ghunna, or the volume of the ghunna, is decided by the letter that comes after it. Well, I take it as a rule this. The sound, the volume, not the sound, the volume of the ghunna is decided by the letter that comes after the Nun Sakina.
Min sulalatin min tin. Min sulalatin min tin. Min sulalatin min tin.
You see, the last one has stronger volume because the volume is high. Why? Because, or like heavy, because of the ta.
Min sulalatin min tin.
If I reduce of the heaviness, make it thin, then the ta is gonna be close to the ta. Listen.
Min sulalatin min tin.
Why? Because I made the ghunna thin, the volume thin, forced me to have the ta thin. So to have the ta, sometimes you listen and you see your ta is closer to the ta, and you're trying to focus on correcting the ta, and still the mistake is there. Why? Because the solution is not in your pronunciation of the ta, the solution is in the volume of the ghunna. Because you say ta, so my ghunna becomes like oh, min, oh, teen. We'll stop here, inshallah. Tayyib, please have some practice on the ikhfa. So we finished. We continue tomorrow, next time. Just have some examples. But we have finished the ahkam of النون الساكنة. قال والرابع الإخفاء عند الفاضل من الحروف واجب للفاضل في خمسة من بعد عشر رمزها. He told you. In five after ten, so 15 letters. رمزها symbolized by في كلمة هذا البيت قد ضمنتها. رمزها, its symbol. In these words of this verse that I put together. صف ذاتنا كم جاد شخص كم جاد شخص قد سما دم طيبا زد في تقا ضع ظالما. So this verse 16, it does not have full meaning. He put it together to help you remember the letters of the khfa. In this verse, every first letter from every word are the letter. So sif, sad, the, tha, ja, shin, qa, sin, dal, ta, zay, fa, ta, dad, and va. Okay? And then start al mim sur sakin. So for among you who would like to memorize it, will be nice. The whole poem, it's nice. So it rhymes. وَالرَّابِعُ الْإِخْفَاءُ عِنْدَ الْفَاضِلِ. The fourth, حُكُم, is name إِخْفَاء, applied to the rest of the letter. وَاجِبٌ لِلْفَاضِلِ, it applied by obligation of the rest of the letter. فِي خَمْسَةٍ مِنْ بَعْدِ عَشْرٍ رَمْزُهَا, in 15 letters, symbolized in the first words of this verse that I compiled, which is the following. صف ذاتنا كم جاد شخص قد سما دم طيبا زد في تقا ضع ظالما. واضح؟ Any question؟ تفضل. Yes, the noon is covered and you can hear the noon, but not clearly, not ظاهرة. So kind of hidden, you know, very light. And then with the غنّة at its end, it disappear. Like min, so I don't say min, min, it's gonna be min, min, min. That nasalization actually is the one who making hiding the noon. So instead of said min, I said min, min, min. That when you hear some of the sound comes from the noise. So people when they think sound comes from the noise, it's like someone has to emphasize on that. No, actually it comes naturally when you don't pronounce fully the noon. When you don't put the tongue on the top and press it so the noon comes clear, that's, if you don't do that, that's when the sound from the noise comes. So it's naturally. Instead of say, min, I said min, min. So it becomes min, min, nutfa, min, nutfa. Huh? طيب. Let's practice, inshallah, with your recitation, you know, which is nice if you have a mushaf, your own mushaf, you can mark places of the ghunna, where the places, I mean, the iqlab and places of ikhfa, and then you can see in the mushaf that you have, when you read it now, you can see how they put you, that's the ghunna. For example, in every noon that has hukum, you don't find sukoon on top of it. The only sukoon, the sign of sukoon is that's idhar. When you have meem, that's iqlab. When you have shadda, that's idgham. When you don't have nothing, that's ikhfa. Inshallah, we'll have it on the board. When you have, that's right. When you have meem, that's what? That's iqlab. When you have noon and it has sukoon like this, that's idhar. When you have noon and you have the letter after it has shadda, that's idgham. It means the shadda that I cancel the noon and I replace it with that letter. When you have noon with nothing on top of it, that's ikhfa. In the every mushaf that you have. جزاكم الله خيرا وبارك الله فيكم ان شاء الله نفعنا الله وياكم